Welcome to Monday Night DBAH. I'm Tony Jakes, that's Chaz Rotary Dial Andrews, and we've got one-on-one action. The DBAHWE champion, Lobo Trovejando, taking on the All-American-American, Jack Swagger, in a one-on-one contest.
You think that's because of the way he walks, the whole Swagger thing?
No, I think it's his birth name, Mr. and Mrs. Swagger. Several decades ago and change.
Eustace T. Swagger and his lovely wife, Beulah Swagger.
Yes. I'm not gonna lie, Beulah Swagger sounds like a pretty cool name.
Right?
Oh, stiff kick.
Is there any other kind?
Well, I don't know. I've seen a couple of your matches. I've seen a couple of weak kicks here and there.
I call them noodle kicks. Just like noodle arms.
Yes, of course. Well, Irish whipping into the ropes. Oh, catching with that impressive hurricanrana.
Oh, that's gotta hurt right there. Oof.
Oh boy.
He's gonna need that arm at some point.
Oh, hammerlock and a chinlock at the same time. It's impressive. Of course, Jack Swagger, known for his technical prowess and his power game as well. It's gonna be an interesting clash of styles. Ooh.
Where is he? Where is AJ Styles?
Oh, no. Clash of. Oh, count one. Ooh, just a one count. Early cover here in this match.
Probably shouldn't do that. The whole crowd will start chanting him.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah. Oh,
Swagger pulling his head out from between Lobo's legs.
Yeah, we don't want this arena turning into Royal Rumble 2015. Or do we?
Oh, almost into Dave Davis. Oh my goodness, big move.
Ow. He's going to need those pectorals at some point. We call that swag control.
Do we call it that? Is that a thing we call it?
That's what all the kids are calling. I'm sorry, you're not in with the in crowd.
I'm not hip to that.
Everybody in the locker room is calling it that.
Well, I don't go in there because, you know, I'm not an investigative journalist. I'm just a broadcaster, so.
Noodle arms.
Oh my goodness. Deep arm drag.
Big toss.
Hooks the leg. One. Another one count. Lobo, need to put in some more work before Jack Swagger's gonna...
Ow!
You know, you can't feel that, Chaz. That's not you in the ring anymore. Oh my goodness! Going crazy.
It's not his strange voodoo power?
No, that's not. Papa Shango's not anywhere around. Alright, one. Two. Ooh, very close count.
Don't get me started on Papa Shango. Yes. Oh, God, yes. Bad chicken blood.
Nope. Swagger. Oh, my goodness. Short arm clothesline.
Imagine if he had really long arms. Would that be a long arm clothesline?
I don't know what a long arm clothesline would be. That sounds like someone's finishing move. Oh, my God. It's into the cover. Hook in the leg. One. Just a one count. After that chop block, though, it might have done more damage than either of us realize.
I didn't realize it.
No. We were very unaware.
I was hopeful, though. I was hopeful.
Oh, boy. Jack Swagger gearing up for something here. What's he got planned? Oh, boy. Oh, this gut wrench. Power bomb. Oh, my goodness. What an impact. Hooks the leg. One. Two. Just kicking out his Lobo Trovejando. Not stirring so much, though. Lobo kind of on the ropes now at this point. Swagger sizing him up. Oh.
Lobo is on a rope bow.
You want to take that one back and we're on again?
Never.
I gotcha.
Never surrender! Sorry.
Careful.
I know, we'll get content ID because I'm too good.
Oh, how's from the hill? Speaking of too good, here's the cover, hook in the leg. One, two, three, and that is it. Lobo Trovejando taking the All-American down a peg. Continues to ride that high from a Survivor Series victory.
I wonder if Eustace and Beulah will ever be the same now that their son has just been decimated by Lobo Trovejando.
tuned for our next match. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a 1-1 contest between Lobo, Trovejando and Terminator. And, well, Chaz, look who's coming down to ringside. Look, it's the opponent from last week, Jack Swagger.
The son of Eustace and Beulah. Here at ringside. They're alright, by the way, I called them.
That's good. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Tony Jakes, that's Chaz, Morse Code Andrews, and,
Morse code.
I don't even know what kind of swear word that was.
You really don't want to know.
Once again, Lobo taking on another robot seems to be a bad string of bad luck for him.
Mainly because I don't even know. Yeah, he's like Lobo Robot Fighter. They're gonna have a whole like comic book series named after him.
Actually, I would pay for that. Probably $2.99, not $3.99.
Right.
Unless the artist was really good.
Much like DC, drawing the line at $2.99.
There you go.
Unless you're a print book.
Right. Lobo breaking the Robo leg there.
Oh.
Oh my goodness! Vicious headbutt from the Terminator. Arnold T1, obviously the bad guy one, not the good guy one.
Do you think that Lobo's brother would be Brobo? Right.
Oh,
right.
Big standing drop kick.
Mark it down in your calendar. It does not happen often.
Trying to chop the big robot down. Not working. Needs a face plant.
Well, I can't tell. This looks like an older model. I don't think his brain is a neural net process. A learning computer, as you would call it.
I think it's the same model. I don't think they changed models between the documentaries. Oh, that dropkick just doesn't phase him. Neither does that punch. Oh, that forearm does.
Yeah, but remember there was that software update?
Was there?
That made all of them just eat Cheetos at once? It
like
kind of messed it up.
What happened?
Apparently you didn't watch the documentary.
I must have. Maybe I missed that part. I may have gone to the kitchen to get Cheetos. Oh my goodness.
Oh, maybe you're a robot.
The cover. One.
Noodle armed robot.
What?
Nothing.
Oh, jawbreaker.
Robo jawbreaker.
Oh my goodness, running neckbreaker there.
So many things are being broken on this robot right now. I'm ready to see springs and oils jumping out of them. Would you say he's being a
Lobo?
Oh
my goodness.
Assaulting that cranium like some sort of cerebral assassin?
We both made kind of puns.
We kinda did.
Two.
We are so good at this job.
Yeah, that's why we get paid the big imaginary bucks. Oh my goodness, just suplex him and toss him away.
The move of the suplex toss-em. Yes.
Indeed. Oh, whipped into the corner.
Gee, I wonder what's going to happen now.
Well, Jack Swagger, got some words for our champion here. Lobo taking his eye off the ball and the robot. Eats a fist. And, there he goes.
I'm sorry, I looked down to play some crosswords, on my, phone. What's the name of that little turtle thing that rides the cloud in the Mario games?
It's Donkey Kong.
I don't think that's it, because it starts with an L. No, that's his brother.
Oh, hey. I was a Sega guy. I'm just gonna throw that. Yeah.
It looks like... Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. Just beating up against the ring apron there.
I don't see Jack Swagger. Did something happen with Jack Swagger? I don't see him there anymore.
Six count now. Lobo's still stunned on his feet.
Cool. He ain't looking too good.
Referee of count of seven. Lobo will make it back into the ring. The Terminator just taunting a little bit. Oh, boy.
Oh, holy. Oh, my goodness. Oh.
Single shoulder powerbomb into the cover. One, two, three. Jackknife cover gets the win for the Terminator over
Yikes.
The DBAHWE champion. Thanks to a little bit of interference from Jack Swagger.
I don't think that's necessarily right. I think that there should be a separate robot league and a separate human league. Because, I mean, I'm trying not to be, but with Steel, there's not that much give in Steel where bones can break.
Listen, Omnics are our friends, not food. I think I'm conflating my media here.
I have eaten so much Omnic in my time. It's not even funny. Why are you just telling me this now?
You're a monster.
I am.
Stay tuned for our next match.
Garar.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Monday Night DBAH. I'm Tony Jakes, that's Chaz, Smoke Signal Andrews, and, oh my goodness, Dave Davies is down. All bets are off.
Shots fired!
We got one-on-one action for you. Lobo Trovejando again taking on Jack Swagger, perhaps looking to get a little bit of a retribution after Jack Swagger interfered in his match, in Lobo's match with the Terminator last week.
Big time messed with his steez. Mm-hmm.
Indeed. Oh, big slugging right. Pressing against the ropes. Boy. Irish whip. Oh. Impressive.
Quite impressive, yes.
I believe that was a wheelbarrow suplex. I believe that's what they call that, Chaz?
Yes, it was indeed. I was temporarily blinded by pain because I hit that part of my ankle that's really... It just hurts. It hurts so bad. So bad.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Wowzers. Ow.
Riveting as always.
Right.
Oh, dropping the elbow right across the back of the neck there.
You know, wheels on the bottoms of these chairs might help certain wrestlers get back into the ring at Royal Rumble, but as far as ankle hazards, these are just a hazard. Oh... Well, that's not good.
Ooh, big suplex there. All-American going to work now on the Thundering Wolf.
Who?
That's what Lobo Trovejando means.
What?
Thundering Wolf. Yep, yeah.
Holy cow.
I think we've been over this. I feel like this has happened. Oh my goodness.
We have been doing this for 17 years, so I forget things sometimes. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's true, but I mean, Lobo Trovejando hasn't been around that long.
This is also true.
It's technically, I mean, depending on your scale of time, it's either been, you know, a year, 2 years, or a couple of weeks. Oh, it's the one count. By a couple of weeks, I mean, you know, a couple of months.
Right, exactly.
Like almost a year. It's either been a couple of years or almost a year.
I think it's been almost a year.
Lobo Trovejando able to convert that spear into a DDT. Impressive work there by the Team DBAH champion.
I like how you say champion.
Champion.
I like that.
Oh boy.
Oh no.
Jack Swagger going off the rope. Oh my goodness.
Just...
Rope assisted bulldog there. Not your bulldog.
No, I don't bring him in here anymore.
It's in the way of all the towels.
No, it's just that when I kept on puking because of somebody spitting green mist on people, I decided to leave him at home.
elbows to the sternum. Oh boy, going crazy here.
He's going nuts.
Pouncing on Jack Swagger. Over Trovejando, ascending to the top turnbuckle.
What's he doing now? Maybe he's just having a sit.
Just crouching.
He's thinking about things.
Wait.
He's got a lot on his mind.
Reviewing, maybe surveying. Huh. Up. Yep.
Oh,
I think he knew Jack Swagger was planning something, so he decided not to do that.
Hmm.
Oh boy. Toss him to the outside. He's got planned here. Ooh, big slugging right.
Oh.
Oh. Ooh. Turning it around with that jawbreaker there. Ooh, throwing it back in the ring. Oh, now choking him. Come on, Jack. Come on, Mr. Swagger.
More like, come on, Dave Davies.
How would your parents feel about you choking out another man on the apron?
I can call them. I have their number.
I mean, not right now. We're in the home. You know, maybe later as part of your, like, investigative journalism.
You know what? I thought you were talking to me. I didn't know you were... Okay, now I get what happened.
No, yeah, I was
confused.
You know, hopefully, when Jack Swagger watches this match back, he'll hear my comments and be like, yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
My parents wouldn't approve of that.
I don't think.
Oh, Lobo dropping the leg right across the neck there.
I believe Lobo was raised by wolves, so I can't call his parents to find out how they felt about that.
Right. Oh boy, Lobo.
Okay.
Oh. Oh my goodness, sitting on the outside.
That's gotta hurt. That ground is pretty hard.
It's a long way up, and they were a long way down.
Right. Isn't that one big metaphor for careers here in the DBAH WWE? Takes so long to get to the top, but it can be knocked down in an instant.
Indeed. One has to wonder when that second part is happening to you. Oh, Lobo turning around. Oh, count of five now.
Noodle-armed little punk.
Both men back in the ring now. Squaring off. Oh, big elbow. Oh, and a chop block. That's going to do some damage. Hooks the leg. One, two. Oh, very
close count. Very close count there. Oof.
Jack Swagger almost pinning. WWE champion.
This isn't horseshoes. This isn't hand grenades, and this isn't bocce. Almost isn't gonna cut it this time.
Oh, oh, big snap there. Now working the arm now. Oh, Jack Swagger powering out. Ooh, stiff right to the gut, knocking the wind out of him. Oh, catches him with that head scissors.
Oof.
Straight into the cover, hooking the leg. One, two. Just a two count.
Just a two count. It almost looked like Swagger's legs were under the ropes as well. So.
Well, you're all surprised that Dave Davies didn't see that.
I know. I'm not.
Oh, snap! Air rolls through and a kick for good measure.
Might as well kick. Go ahead and kick.
Oh, Paulista plunge.
Unreleased song by Van Halen.
Looked like he was going for River's End. Hooks the leg, though. One, two, three. Oh, that was infinitesimally close.
River's End, more like Rivers Cuomo. Weezer.
What?
Nothing.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my goodness. The House of the Hills.
One of them.
Hooks the leg. One. Two, three, and that is it. Lobo Trovejando once again taking down Jack Swagger. But what is that? I gotta think the animosity building between these two means they're gonna have a match at TLC. What? Just 1 week away.
Well, oh, look at that.
Forget what I said about animosity. These two like each other, right. I guess. Which is weird.
Well, at least maybe they have some respect for each other.
Yeah, I guess so. Stay tuned for our next match. But But you know, we've got tag team action here for you. A little some kerfuffle here between Lobo Trovejando and rival Jack Swagger as two arguing who's going to start up first.
Maybe it's animosity.
Perhaps animosity. So we've got tag team action here. I'm Tony Jakes. That's Chaz. Telegram Andrews.
You took a while to get there, just like a telegram.
Oh boy. Jack Swagger starting things off against Jimmy English.
Jimmy English, you have to just think, is he even recovered from
Survivor Series?
Has he recovered from the onslaught of AJ Styles, Matthias Sin, and Charlie Danger? Because, boy howdy, wow.
Just beating the ever-loving Sterling out of him. Oh my goodness, turn him over there.
I watched that match just the other day again, and just our pleads just went unheard by Team DBAH.
Oh, a fierce succession of kicks by Mr. English there.
He's angry. He is very angry.
Of course, depending on your perception of time, that was either 1 week ago or at least 4 weeks ago, so, you know.
Oh,
whatever measure of time you're using.
Sweet Jiminy Crickets. Oh, my goodness.
Running neckbreaker from the champion. Turning him over. What's got planned here? Oh, a little cattle mutilation here.
Ouch.
Going for it here. He's got... Let's go with the hold. Jimmy English, as per usual, in a bad way.
Maybe that's just how he likes it? Question mark?
Maybe so. Maybe it's like I'm thinking of a comparable situation. You know what I mean? Like the
uphill battle.
Damaged, the more he gets damaged, like the stronger he gets.
Oh.
And now tags in Dave Davies Jr.
So he's like Bishop in a weird way. The more energy that's shot at him, the more he absorbs and redirects.
Or like a Saiyan, like the closer he comes to death.
Oh wow.
Yeah. The stronger he gets.
Yeah. Hey, Jimmy English, when Broly?
I don't even know what that means. Oh, my goodness, reverse DDT.
Where is the script for this match?
Lobo tagging in Jack Swagger. Two big men going to go at it. Oh. Well, Jack Swagger's not afraid of heights, but he may be after that.
That's terrifying right there. Don't know exactly what agenda lies under that mask.
Besides impressing his pseudo-dad, perhaps.
Pseudo-dad. Nobody expects a thing. Pseudo-dad. Pseudo-dad.
Is that a reference to something, or did you just make that up on the spot?
No, that's a reference to Octo-dad, actually.
Gotcha. That one dad that had, like, the 16 kids?
Yeah.
The 8 kids?
Yeah.
Okay. Forgot what Octo meant at first. Oh my goodness. Oh, big tilt-a-whirl sidewalk slam.
Octo is 8, by the way.
Well, you know, I never took Greek, so. tagging in. Lobo Trovejando again. Dave Davies back into the ring now. The two masked men gonna go at it. Oh, stiff knee.
That's gonna get your head ringing a little bit there. Because that's quite a knee to be hit with.
Spinner. Oh my goodness. Impressive whirling DDT there. Not to be used with a whirling dervish. Oh, trips him up. Makes the tag to Jimmy English. Stepping back in the striped trunks.
Oh boy. Oh.
Runs right into a pounce.
Sheesh.
Oof. Into the cover, hooks the leg. 1, 2. Nope, just a 2 count.
Little too soon, Mr. Lobo.
Stephanie going to work now.
Apparently someone haven't seen Survivor Series. This is called just warming up to Jimmy English.
Oh, big crucible bomb there. Ooh, catches him with the arm drag. Oh, blocks the head scissors. Oh my goodness, turn it into a powerbomb. impressive strength from the British wrestler. Oh, boy. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, check your pulse. It's the heart punch.
I'm checking mine right now.
Into the corner now. It's going to happen here. Oh,
oh no.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I just get sick watching this.
It comes. It's weird. Just inverted.
It's just so...
Inverted autumn's fall. It's unnatural. Oh, my goodness.
So unnatural.
The leaves are turning color, and there's this faint stench of bloodlust in the air. Hooks the leg. Dave Davies Sr., a little slow on the take there. Perhaps just so proud of his son, he forgot his job for a minute. And now a brawl has broken out.
Alleged
son. Oh, boy. Oh, howls from the hills.
Oh, going in.
Hooks the leg. One, two. Oh, just a two count. Oh, my goodness. You see... Jimmy English just get flung with an arm drag by Jack Swagger on the outside.
And now he's on the inside.
I'm around. Oh, man. Freaky with it. Davy Splash.
Wait, that's what he calls it? The Davy Splash?
Mm-hmm. Wow. No, one-handed bulldog.
Feel it, feel it. Feel the vibrations.
Going into the corner.
In the corner, he should come out swinging. Come out swinging.
Oh, another rope-assisted bulldog. Hooks the leg. One, two. Oh,
was that like a fast count of... It almost looked like he was bringing his arm down even quicker to do a three count. It's almost like Dave Davies Sr. was trying to sabotage Dave Davies Jr.
I will manufacture
as much drama as I please, Mister.
I was gonna refute your observation. I was just gonna say that I didn't observe it as so. Oh boy! Oh,
oh
my goodness! Avalanche arm drag. Oh boy, what's got planned here? Oh my! Shot block, digging out the knee.
I always get confused on that move because it always looks like his opponent's rolling out of the way.
One, two. Oh. Jimmy English saving the match. Just immediately vacates the ring. Lobo going right after him now.
Now, is he saving the match or as much as trying to pay back his partner for leaving the round too early at Survivor Series?
I am not sure. Oh, boy. Oh, and there's the gut-wrench powerbomb. That's bad news for the masked wrestler, the masked man. Now, Jimmy English again saving the match. I think you're right about the Survivor Series punch there, Chaz.
Yep. This, he's definitely Xavier Wooden it.
Oh, no! Fireman's carry. Oh, now just... You wanna say it?
Oh, he's braiding his hair!
Yep, there's non-existent hair underneath the mask. He's braiding it. That's how strong it is.
See, I think that Dave Davies should have, like, two ponytails coming out the side.
So pigtails.
Yes. No, pigtails are braided, aren't they?
Are they?
Yeah, I'm talking about like loose ponytails, like Alexa Bliss.
I think you can consider those pigtails.
I do not think it means what you think it means.
I think they're just braided pigtails. Otherwise, that's what we invented adjectives for. Oh boy.
Oh boy.
Full Nelson slam. Tagging in Jimmy English now.
Ooh, that chop, though.
Got planned here. Oh, fierce elbow right to the gut. Spinning him around. Oh, nope. Lobo getting one over on him.
Oh, gosh. Ow.
Twisting neck breaker.
Oh, Jimmy.
Hooks the leg. Lateral plus. One, two. Two count. Jim English staying alive as often want to.
Didn't see Dave Davies rushing in to try to break up that count right there.
Oh, just attacking the head. I think Lobo knows that's where the majority of Jimmy English's punishment was suffered at Survivor Series.
Maybe. I don't think that there was an inch of him that was not damaged after Survivor Series.
That's not inaccurate. Oh.
Oh my God! He bounced him.
German suplex. nice.
He bounced him.
Like a basketball.
Right?
Holy. Just stomping away. Mackerel. Just a boy.
Again, see that's what confuses me so much. It just, he rockets across there like he dodged. Oh.
Out two. Oh, no. Jimmy was just kicking out despite Dave Davies lazily getting in the ring and not breaking up the count.
Essentially, it looked like, oh boy. Oh. Well,
Jimmy was full of fire.
Kicking at the wind.
Just missed and decided not to follow up. Gut wrench powerbomb. Both members of Team Beth Davies left lying. Hooks the leg. One, two, three, and that is it. Jack Swagger picking up the victory for he and Lobo Trovejando.
Can somebody please tell me why Lobo was getting into the ring to break out the count of his own man?
I'm not sure. I'm not 100%. Maybe there's some mind games going on.
Huh? Look at them.
These two look like they're getting along, though.
Former rivals, now best buddies.
I guess so. You know, it just certainly seems like it.
Like Cesaro and African Bush.
Oh yeah, I forgot that happened. Yeah. Anyway, thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to TLC live from San Antonio, Texas. I'm Tony Jakes, that's Chaz Skype call Andrews, and as Lillian would tell you if her mic was working. Yeah, you know the song and dance, ladies and gentlemen. This is the World Heavyweight Championship match. The DBAHWE Heavyweight Championship match, and it is a tables, ladders, and chairs match.
A TLC match.
On the way to the ring is the challenger, Jack Swagger. He's hyped up, looking, I guess, fresh in that jacket?
Fresh to death?
You know.
Fresh or French?
Fresh. Like cream fresh?
That must be what it is. He's looking very fresh.
Indeed. Looking to, you know, he's an Oklahoma boy, but he's looking to make the Texas proud or something. I'm not really sure. He's very American, and sometimes Texans are very American when they're not being Texian, so.
You're being very Texas?
Yeah, I'm making all kinds of judgment calls.
And I will not stand for that. See, one of those sound guys has a hat. You're going to offend him.
I mean, just because he has a hat doesn't mean he's from Texas. I mean, that one is from Texas.
That definitely means he's from Texas.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I know.
But, wait. Hang on. What's his name? Lucas Gospel wears a hat. Is he from Texas?
Yes.
Oh. Well, dang it. Anyway, and there's our DBAHWE World Heavyweight Champion, Lobo Trovejando. Making his way to the ring. And
looking very intimidating, rising from the smoke. What is that on the screen?
It's something, all right. It's something.
That paint and water.
Of course, in a tables, ladders, and chair match, there are no rules, no disqualifications, no countouts. Pinfalls must happen inside the ring. The use of tables, ladders, and chairs is encouraged.
Just like Olive Garden, no rules, just right.
I believe that's Outback.
You know, I think you're right about that. I think you're right.
I think Olive Garden. Garden is eating good in the neighborhood.
And it's come for the breadsticks, stay for the company.
Like the company of Olive Garden?
No, no, no. The company of the people you're with.
Oh, what if you eat alone?
Then you're going to have a sad time. Because there's no one to enjoy your breadsticks with. So, I said it. Don't go to Olive Garden alone.
And remember when I said that pinfalls was happening inside the ring? Yeah, I forgot the championship on suspended above the ring. You got to climb a ladder to get it.
Oh, yeah, you did forget about that part.
Listen, in 20-something years of broadcasting, sometimes I'm going to get some things wrong.
We've been doing this for a year. You yelled at me
or
last time.
Or almost 2 years, depending on your point of view.
Everything I say is true from a certain point of view.
Hey, this statement is a lie.
Whoa, stop it. You're blowing my mind.
Oh my goodness. Jawbreaker. Oh, stiff right. Oh, and a big thrust kick.
Yikes. This is just... All that... You know, all that good feelings between the two of them is... Seems like it's gone out the window when that title is dangled precariously over the ring.
Yeah, I mean these two had a championship victory, or not a championship victory, excuse me, a tag team victory over a very accomplished tag team in Team Meth Thieves, and impressive little twisting head scissors there.
He was his brother. He was supposed to bring balance to the title, not destroy it.
I think he's brought peace and prosperity to his new wrestling federation.
Oh. Liar!
From his point of view, the authority are evil. Oh, dodges the ladder with Neo-like quickness there.
Everyone knows the authority is not evil.
Well, wrestling over the ladder now.
The tradition of passing the ladder.
That's why you're coming away with it.
Ow! Them's is his feetsies. He's gonna need them's.
Why is he attacking the legs?
Again with the feetsies.
If he ain't got no legs.
Well, he sprang up with the power of 1,000 wolves.
Oh my goodness. Returning the measure there.
Yeah, you might just want to put that ladder up as opposed to just. Never mind.
Nope, going for something here.
Is he?
Oh! This is with the moonsault.
Yikes. Thought he was gonna gargoyle it like he did last week, like a couple weeks ago.
Or you know, earlier today.
Time is fluid, Tony Jakes. Time is fluid.
It's kind of in one or two states. Either is or it isn't.
Right. It's either ice or not ice.
Right. Or like plasma.
Ooh.
One of the two.
Right. Yeah.
The rare fourth state. It's like rock, paper, scissors, gun.
Ooh. Oh. Like, get out of here.
Springing back into action, though. Oh. I'm not sure what happened to the ladder there.
The ladder just said, screw this, I'm out. You guys can fight this out amongst yourselves.
Modified side rush and leg sweep is Lobo going after the ladder, the errant ladder.
Oh, wow. Nicked his
unfazed.
Something.
Oh. Oh boy, what's gonna land here? Oh my goodness.
Something that's gonna hurt. That's for dang sure.
Fisherman's neck breaker there.
Holy moly.
Stomping away now.
Stomping away on Lobo Trevijando's knees. Like,
oh my goodness. Just
I don't know
going after the that. Neck. Can't climb a ladder if you ain't got no neck.
That's inaccurate, I feel. You don't need a neck to climb a ladder.
No. What?
You don't need a neck to climb a ladder.
Then how is your head attached to your body? And then if it's not attached, how are you still alive?
There's ligaments going on there. There's arteries and stuff.
In that part of the neck that rolls through. Oh my goodness, big kick.
Well, if you didn't have a neck, your head would just be attached to your shoulders. So it would still be on there.
But then you couldn't breathe because you wouldn't have no esophagus or windpipe or
No, it would be integrated to the other parts of your body, you see.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
And to look around, you would just need to Batman it. You know, Michael Keaton Batman it. Just turn, turn.
I see now. Oh, Lobo.
Hey,
weird stare down here. Nope. Well, slips on the ladder. That's embarrassing.
Oh, that is embarrassing. They know they're supposed to use that ladder, right? Anyone tell them?
It's you know, a lot of things go on in this match.
Oh, Lobo, you don't open it outside the ring, honey. You put it in the... Okay. All right. Oof.
Oh, no.
Oh boy.
Goodness.
Again with the... Oh.
Dodges. Nope. Out of the way in just in time. Oh, man, just grab that one out of the air.
Like, give me that.
Dueling on the... Oh, ho, ho.
Oh,
I'm taking out the legs.
How do you? How does that feel for you there, JS?
Oh, oh, scooting the ladder into the ring.
Ooh.
He's got Bland here. Oh, toss him over the rope.
The dreaded ladder scoop.
Not gonna knock him off though. Just gonna grab the ladder right now and set it up away from the title.
Away from the title. Wow.
Interesting strategy. By interesting, I mean.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Hey.
I'm sorry.
Family show.
Oh, no, dives right to the ladder.
Oh, my God.
With that pounce.
Again with these. I mean, were the rules explained to them? I mean, yeah, you were explaining the rules. I assume that they would know the rules before they would come in there.
Well, in fairness, I explained one set of rules that was wrong and then another set of rules that was right.
No wrong.
He's got his hands on the title. He's got
just
his
right.
Title. Nope.
Just like Olive Garden.
Of course, Lobo Trovejando was able to win the DBAHWE Championship after, you know, winning the Money in the Bank ladder match. So one would think he's got some experience here. But Jack Swagger also was a winner of that Money in the Bank ladder match.
Uh-oh.
Not the same
Uh-oh.
One, obviously, but
obviously not the same one. Yes.
Right. Jack Swagger, former World Heavyweight Champion, looking to get DBAHWE gold for the first time, and not the World Heavyweight Championship, which is like the
Uh-oh.
Big gold belt. Oh boy, ascending the ladder now.
Oh, slowly, but he's super
though.
Tired. It's gonna take him a while.
Well,
he's up there.
Not stirring. Yep, he did it. All right, well, that was it.
Wow.
Yep. Very, very anticlimactic. Lobo doesn't even know he's lost yet. I mean, maybe he heard the ring bell, but.
Wow.
Yep, Jack Swagger is our new DBAHWE Heavyweight Champion.
Just change his hands so many times. I just it'll make head spin.
I'll tell you what, Chaz.
Yeah.
If you would have done this match, I would say like two more times. I think you would have seen the same result.
That's very true.
But you know, just
that's fair.
It's the way these two came into it. I don't think Lobo was taking Jack Swagger very seriously. Jack Swagger, on the other hand.
Why'd he climb the ladder again?
What?
Why'd he climb the ladder again?
Because he wants to be really tall.
Oh, right. Okay.
He's already tall. He wants to be even taller. It's like an ego kind of thing.
Huh.
The living planet, not the psyche.
Right. Exactly. Like there was any other kind.
Well, yeah. The psyche. That's the thing.
Your face is a psyche.
Wow. All right. And it's offensive.
Uh huh.
Anyway. Yep.
A lot of celebrating he's doing here. Can't help but notice.
Very happy, won the gold. Thank you for watching. Don't be a hero.
Good night.